London, less than 3 days after the United Kingdom became the first nation ever to leave the European Union, the two sides on Monday set out competing positions on the terms of their future relationship, in what could be the biggest showdown yet between them.
While the UK says it won't follow EU rules after Brexit, Brussels argues this is the price for getting a comprehensive trade deal.
In an ornate hall in Greenwich, southeast London, where 18th-century paintings celebrate Britain's prosperity and power, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson said the UK was ready to take off its Clark Kent spectacles and leap into the phone booth and emerge with his cloak flowing as the supercharged champion of the right of populations of the earth to buy and sell freely among each other.
He stressed that the UK wanted a thriving trade and economic relationship with the EU, but made clear that the UK would not be bound by European standards on social legislation, state aid and the environment in any agreement.
Are we going to insist that the EU does everything that we do as the price of free trade? Of course not, he said, as he reassured the EU that Britain wasn't leaving to undermine the 27-nation bloc.
Johnson also expressed excitement about striking a trade deal with the US, but stressed that the publicly funded National Health Service wasn't on the table, and that tariffs on Scotch whisky should be cut.
Earlier, the EU's chief negotiator Michel Barnier warned that the UK that could have access to its market of 450 million consumers as part of a wide-ranging trade deal, but only if it abides by EU standards.
Calling Brexit a somber and emotional moment, Barnier said in Brussels on Monday that the talks were an opportunity for a new relationship, as he released the bloc's draft negotiating guidelines.
When you're not a member of the European Union, then your position is different and less favourable, said Barnier on Monday.
This has never been done, and it's a real challenge to come up with a trade agreement like the ones we have with Canada, or South Korea or Japan, he added later in the press conference.
The UK's divorce from the EU became official on Friday night at 11 p.m, 3.5 years after the nation voted to leave the bloc in a referendum on June 23, 2016. Despite its official departure, the UK will still be subject to all EU laws and regulations until at least the end of 2020 in a transition period that could be extended by up to 2 years.
During that time, the UK will need to secure an agreement on its future relationship with the EU, including the finer details of trade, security and data sharing, a task that most experts and the EU itself says will be nearly impossible to complete in full with such a short time frame.
Official post-Brexit talks won't start until next month, after the guidelines have been formally approved by the EU member states.
As the UK officially left, the EU had warm words of farewell, but it has repeatedly made it clear that it would look after the interests of its member nations.
We are proud of everything the EU and UK have achieved together, said a video about Brexit that Barnier posted on Twitter on Saturday. But our loyalty lies foremost with EU citizens.
EU leaders have repeatedly warned that the deadline of December 31, 2020 makes the timetable too tight to strike a full trade deal.
Free trade agreements typically take years. The EU-Canada deal that the British government cites as a potential model for its future framework took 7 years to negotiate.
If there is no deal by the end of 2020, and the UK refuses to extend the negotiating period, Britain faces an abrupt, disruptive economic break from the bloc, with tariffs and other obstacles to trade imposed immediately between the UK and the EU.
That prospect alarms many businesses, especially in sectors such as the auto industry, which depend on the easy flow of parts across borders.